as we are all aware that disaster strikes many parts of the world every year, and they are in the form of whether it is earthquake or it is flood or it is tsunami or any flash floods, etc. So these are inevitable as such, but we need to prepare ourselves for the disaster so as to mitigate the effects of the disaster, which affects not only our social life, but it affects the economy of the nation as a whole. So the objective of this particular study question is to have management for disaster risk reduction so as to mitigate the effect of the disaster. In this question, we are studying, we are examining the various kinds of technologies which can be utilized for disaster prediction, its preparedness, its monitoring, its rescue and relief operations, and post-disaster effect. And by this way, we are collaborating and cooperating with each other to share our knowledge and the best practices so as to prepare the emergency telecommunication plan to put in place so as to have been better prepared whenever a disaster comes. ICT's role of ICT is very well known, whether it is disaster prediction or preparedness, by way of communication, because during the disaster or before the disaster, the information flow is very, very important. The information has to be timely, predictable, and effective. And when this vital flow of information is important for the governments and other agencies which are involved in disaster application, disaster management, for that, whether it is information coming from mobile network or from satellite network or from the internet, this is this plays a very, very important role. So communication is a preliminary thing, and we have to have effective effective ICT network in place so that whenever disaster strikes, we should have the early warning system in place, and we are better prepared using ICT. Nowadays, when we are moving towards era of IoT and machine to machine communication, their role becomes more and more important. With the help of the sensors and actuator, when we put on the seabed or ocean floors or at the various portion of the earth, we can come to know about the movement of the earth, and we can detect that whether any inevitable disaster is going to strike. This helps us to have better prepare. And using the satellite communication, whenever there is a infrastructure collapse takes place in terms of terrestrial infrastructure, we can have better communication even during the disaster and after the disaster. So ICT plays a very, very important role. And post-disaster also, anthropological challenges which we face, ICT plays an important role in overcoming those challenges. Disaster preparedness is a continuous process, and it requires continuous updation in our preparedness. So as ITU provide a very good platform for all the nation to come and collaborate and share their knowledge, the developed nation which are having resources and knowledge, when they share their experiences, the developing nation or the nation which get affected frequently due to disaster can prepare themselves, then can prepare their emergency telecommunication plan in place. And whenever they pose their challenges before the developed nation, they also come to know that what kind of requirement will be there for the developing nation or the nation which are getting affected by disaster. So that time immediate equipment can be provided and can be transported to other country. And since we understand each other's requirement, so the regulatory enablement or regulatory requirement can be fulfilled very early, so that ICT equipment is put in place during the time of disaster.